Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm out here in North Entrance. Hopefully you can hear me all right. I'm trying to cover the speaker. I'm looking at this dune here. It's looking pretty cool. I'm liking the shadows in here, and then I'm liking the tree there. And then I'm also liking all the sunlight there, and the water there is looking sick. I've got this bit of a vertical type of a panel today because I wanted to paint vertically. So I think this scene would actually work really nicely for a vertical sort of scene. So I might try and do a sketch or something and then see how it looks and work it out from there. I didn't actually intend for this scene specifically. I just felt like driving over here and this worked out good. I did get a couple of nice drawings in. I don't know if you can see that too well. I got three, not so happy, kind of happy, a bit more happy. I think I'm gonna blend these two together sort of thing. I've got this sort of shadow here that's coming through here. That's how far it sort of stretches, same with here. So I've got those two shadow shapes in there. The tree and the horizon line a bit up. I've expressed the tree a bit more here, so it's a bit higher. Made the tree a bit smaller here and stuff. So I've played around with a few things. I might do a combo of both these ones when I get to the painting itself. So we've got about a couple of hours, so I'm gonna get those two started and we're gonna start painting.
So from this point in the video, I actually plugged in my Rode microphone. It's like that Rode microphone Go. It's like that shotgun microphone. Anyways, long story short, it messed up the audio and it all sounds pretty bogus. Not all of it. Some parts are like pretty usable. Like I'm still going to use majority of the original audio for the most of the part of this video because I did want this to be another real time video, and I feel like you can still get quite a lot out of it because I still think quite a bit of the audio is still quite usable. So I'm just going to go ahead, but please know that from this point on, the Rode mic kind of messes the audio up quite a bit, and I'll endeavor to try and make that not happen ever again. But to talk about the sketching, I'm just translating the pen drawing up onto the sketch onto the canvas, and I'm super happy with it, and I'm loving the whole foundations of this painting.
Right, I'm happy with the sketch. I'm gonna put the sketchbook away, and then we're gonna start mixing up some colors. Let's start with the sky. I like to always start with the sky. Maybe a bit stronger. lighter blue. Some bits of clouds, but I'm kind of going to gesture them, I think, make up some little... make up some things to do with them. I'm going to put some white over there just to have that there. Where's my flat? I'm going to use the flat, I think. Maybe I'll just use, I'll save the flat and use to fill it, I think, for the sky. I mean, you can see it's already kind of blue from the other day painting over at that farm. And it's bring you up here. Again, using these blues to sort of create these negatives where I want to put these clouds in. Mimic this sort of shape here, but with a cloud over here. of our other colours now. Let me get rid of that. Sweep all that off. I'm keeping some of that sky there, actually, just in case I need it for anything to do with the trees and stuff. So now, you've probably seen this process before, but I'm going to start mixing my colours for the rest of the landscape here. Let me just wipe that off. Get rid of that. Into the plastic bag it goes. Another paper towel there. Right, so let's mix up some of these other colours that I'm seeing here. Well, first of all, beach theme. Let's get quite a lot of that sand in. There is quite a lot of that sand. Just some yellow ochre, titanium white. If you mix that right, you know, nice rhyme, but if you mix this right, you kind of get this really nice sand color by default, just from those two. I'm pretty happy with that. Maybe give it a touch more. Give it a touch more. Maybe a little bit more, actually. There we go. Okay, yeah. Okay, I'm liking the look of that. Now I'm gonna grab some more of that white. Grab some more of that in here. Now I'm making a sort of deeper one with that yellow ochre, because this is going to be the shadow through that landscape here. So I'm going to add some ultramarine blue to it. I like to sort of slowly mix it in, seeing how that looks, stopping and starting. I don't want to overdo it too much, although that shadow is quite dark. Might need to top up that white. It's really important, something I learned, which took me quite a while to learn, was that when you run out of colors, top them up. Because what ends up happening is you start to compensate for the colors you don't have and start mixing very thin and trying to get colors from colors that you actually don't actually have left on your palette. So mix well and fill up when you run out. Add some more in there, some more here. I'm gonna actually make that a bit bluer, not too blue. I don't want it to be too blue. Maybe add some more yellow ochre through here. It makes this nice sort of green, but when you get this shadow on already sort of yellowish sand, it does sort of tend to make a green. Now I'm gonna make some sort of lighter version of it as well as darker version of it, because there are parts of the shadow which are lighter than other parts, and there's parts which are darker. So this is semi-dark, but I might pull some more things to make that even more so when I get it out. Now I've got a lot of these nice greens on the beach here. I'm gonna add some of that blue. Some of those nice greens. Far away green there. It's a little bit more pastel-y. And then I've got some closer greens. Not too many of them, so I won't mix up too much of it. Maybe a littlest touch of cad red into your green can make them look a bit more realistic, instead of having this sort of super vibrant green, which which looks fluorescent. That cad red sort of dulls it down, reins it in a little bit more, and I find sort of makes it look a bit more lifelike, a bit less, like I said, fluorescent. There's some watches here. Got some people watching behind me. I'm gonna mix in some of this darker green here as well. Something for this tree in the foreground here that I can pull from in a bit. It's still green, it's not entirely this strange grey colour, so I still want to get some of that green through there. Maybe pull from it. Yeah, that's nice. And then I'm gonna need some darker tones as well. For the seaweed on the sand. But I'm going to mix it a bit more warmer, so I've got a bit more burnt umber than ultramarine in this mix. It's just a bit warmer, so I can key that how I want to when I come to it. Set it back up and we'll get started. I'm gonna mix up this sort of pastely green for a lot of this area out here because it is further away. It's a bit more pastel green. Oh, you know what the funny thing is as well, I just realized, is that one of the other videos I was painting up at these dunes up over here. So it's always funny when I paint the same location but from a different angle. This part is, I guess, from quite a long way away compared to what it was. When I was standing right on top of it. But it's always cool to see that when it does happen. I'm gonna make this pastely darker green for this sort of back here as well. As well as some of the shadows through here. A lot of that is that pastel green, but darker. I don't want to put too much emphasis and detail into this scene, because I want most of the emphasis to be around here, the foreground, mid-ground to the area, maybe up around the tree, a bit more than I wanted in the back here, understandably. So this beach does have a bit of shadow going through it, so I'm going to kind of use some of this shadow to pop through back here as well. Might make it a bit bluer, it's a bit further away. So all I'm doing is adding a bit more ultramarine blue to the mix there. Less saturated, probably less saturated. slapping some of this dark green around here. Yeah, well, how long are we in? We're about like maybe half an hour or so into the video, hey. Oh man, I feel like I want to talk about more than just what I'm doing in the painting while I'm painting here. It might be a bit more entertaining, you know. What's been happening? Not much. I've been trying to work on my Patreon page a lot. Shout out Sketcher. He's the first in on the Patreon. Most of you probably know, but it, you know, I had my daughter, Aura, and that sort of threw the spanner in the works in terms of making content for the Patreon page, because, you know, I've been looking after her. You know what I mean? So that's kind of been where the Patreon has been at. I mean, I've written a few blog posts in there. When I say a few, I mean like two. And they're pretty good. I'm pretty happy with the blog posts and stuff. But, you know, the videos and all those other things are coming. They're just going to take a bit more time. You know, I initially wanted it to be more so like a learning place, you know, so where like people could come and we could have like one-on-one sort of private learning. It's like a one-on-one tutoring sort of thing is what I want it to be like, more so than a more so than like a video teaching place. So that's kind of the gist of that. Going forward here, just around here to the area. There's some sand dunes up through here. I'm putting in around there. Might want to try and fix up some of these trees by adding in some more blue. Hopefully my battery charger doesn't run out by the time I finish up this painting. I don't think it will. I think if anything's going to go first, it'll probably be the sun. The sun will probably be the first thing to go out of everything. And then the battery. I'm calling it now. But I hope not. I hope it all just chills out and stays good. So this here is a bit of an older panel as well, because I'm using this sort of pine, and you can see I've heavily textured it with the gesso, which is what I like. You know, I like that sort of texture, you know, running through it. I like canvas texture, it's nice and all. But it might be overdoing it a little bit, I think, because you can kind of see a lot through the painting, but it might add some nice uniform texture to the painting, you know. It's hard to say right now, but just so we're on the same page, I guess. Right, trying to add in some of this sand through here. A bit too much green on this paintbrush, but just wiping that off. Gonna fit in some of this ocean color as well.
Set up there nicely.
Yeah, it's nice. Put in some of this water through here. I'm gonna cap that water with just some like white through it, I'm thinking. And then it's come to the foreground there a little bit as well. So I'm gonna try and get that in. A bit more wash down with the white there as well. More of that whitewash through there. I'm going to signify that hitting the beach here by putting in some sort of darker where the sand meets the water. You know, this isn't like an integral part of the painting, but it's important still to get it right. You know, it's important still to give it the respect it deserves. Really, it's just the background of the background. Sort of area of the painting, it doesn't really mean much, but then we'd be doing ourselves and it a disservice. By not giving it the respect it deserves. And that's to just completely understand that, you know, every facet of the painting works together all at once, because, you know, I see the whole painting all at once, but then as soon as we've seen it all at once, that's the initial reaction, right? And then as soon as we see it all at once, then we go in and see things different. It's so it's still important to get these parts of it right. Yellow ochre together, so I've got this nice sort of pastely green coming through this section of it. Then we can pick up some more blue through it as well. Switch back to a smaller brush. Whitewash through the water there as well. Still want to pop some sort of highlights through there before I put the waves in. Working through these different sort of blues and I want to get some more white blue through this area before I move on. So that's kind of what's happening. And then I'm gonna pop in some of these whites and waves. Loading up the brush very thickly and sort of applying it impasto-y. Impasto sort of just means thickly. Same with where it hits the wash on the sand there. So looking at my scene now, a lot of the shadows have come right over the top of what I've been painting. So I'm still going off of where my shadows were, because I like that composition a lot more than what it is now. I'll show you what it looks like now. You can see how those shadows have come straight across and now touching the water. I'm still going to follow my what I've initially laid down here. Waves coming in over there. Nice. Yeah, I'm liking that. Alright, let's throw in some of this, the brighter sand through here. Still want to warm it up though when it comes close to that water. The people fishing into it. Don't worry, they're not going. and just fix up some of where the sand is going, and then I might have to move over to a bigger brush when it comes down to here, or I might actually move up over here and then work my way back down. I don't know, see what happens. Stuff and I'm just gonna try and foreground here. Just going to scumble in a couple of what I want some of these seaweeds to look like. Just a bit of green for them. A bit more washed out green, of course. Same with this one up here. I'm not going to spend all my time putting in every bit of seaweed here, because there's quite a bit, but I'll just allude to most part of it. Bringing out a big brush here, so I can pick up the pace. It's bigger. Further down, so you can see all that. Bit of green coming through there, yellow. And then I kind of wanted to sort of come through the foreground enough that it sort of comes out of the painting itself. Real sickly sort of green looking, dried up green coming through off these. Picking up this little flat brush as well, again. This one again as well. Branches. spend all my time again putting in every single branch, every single leaf, you know. I'm gonna just allude to it and then set it down and leave that as so the branches that go up into the tree are a bit darker than what you'll see actually hit the ground. Some more of that sky through here and here. Oop, that's a big lot of sky. Take that off carefully. Try not to bump that too much into the blacks. There's this darker green sort of patch from the tree behind it. I'm trying to put him in there. He's this sort of darker, washed out more green. More of the sky around that too. And then I want to put in these trees. Pick up a smaller brush and just dot them in. Man, this is a beautiful afternoon. Hopefully this video is still entertaining for those that are still watching. I appreciate every single one of you. I don't think this will be too long of a painting, because I'm working rather quickly to get the sunlight sort of racing it. There. Okay, where am I looking now? Okay, so there's this lighter green in the back here. A bit washed out, but still there. That's from the tree behind this tree. Comes through to there-ish. Darkness still comes down. Still got a bit of missing sky through here, so I'm gonna try and dot that in. So now I'm gonna go back into the top of the dune here, sort of work out a few things, because now I'm gonna put in some of these nice, beautiful highlights of the tops of these dunes. And I think it's just gonna really make it look super nice. Just gonna flesh out a lot of these tree trunks a bit more and see them a bit easier. Hitting the top of this dune. Over to here as well, so it's just catching a lot of that, just catching that, and then we're back down into these dark greens again, down that reach down to the dune. So I'm just gonna finish off that, and then I'm gonna put in some of this sort of undertone here where it goes into this nice top of the dune. I'm gonna put that in as well. But some of that grass is this nice, that blue grass. I don't know if that's something else or not, but that's what it looks like here. All right, let's try and put in some of this. Shadow through here. small brush to get into the zoo. A lot of that is messed as well with these branches, so it's not pure, just, you know, sand. But let me know what you think about these longer form videos. If you like them, if you don't like them, if you'd rather me edit them and leave maybe the longer form to the Patreon or something, I don't know, so that, you know, people that are actually interested in the longer form can go over there and watch the longer form over there. I don't know, still working it out, see how people vibe with it, really.
Thank you.
laugh because it's a bit of a dull tree, so it doesn't, when I say highlights, it doesn't really have any. it's this strange sort of dull white colour. And sunset, yeah, it's beautiful. I love to look at the whole sort of scenery around me, it's looking real nice. Right on top of it. else would you call it? Just shrubs, I suppose. I want to flatten out a lot of this shadow part. It's taken off. Just taken off a lot of the impasto sort of ish work. Thank you. sharp.
Fisher, the fisherman. So
moment, but it's not gone. Nice edge to it so I can work around some of this seaweed. really happy with this. Really happy with the way it's turned out. Yeah, I'm loving every aspect of it. I think it's looking really great. I don't know if I'll touch up much, if anything, really. I kind of like the rawness of it, of the whole panel. Yeah, I think it looks really nice. Like, I'm bringing you in here. Yeah, I'm really stoked with the scene. I think the drawing, the composition is what really makes it, is what's really made this scene really nice. I might actually come back here and do a landscape version of this, where this is upwards. I might do a sort of panoramic one a little bit, maybe into the foreground here, the waves a little bit more. Oh, actually, before I start saying everything's done, let me add in those fishermen. Totally forgot. Happy with this scene. I'm super happy with it. I love it. I think it looks sick. I hope you've all been enjoying this video. Alright, so I hope everybody enjoyed this video. I hope you all enjoyed this painting. Sorry if I sound like I'm yelling. I'm just not too sure how much the microphone is picking up. But I hope everybody really enjoyed this this painting, this video. Hope you got a lot out of it. Hope it was entertaining. Hope it was educational. Overall, I hope you enjoy the painting, you know, that's the most important part. I myself, very happy with it. I really love the way it looks. I think that comes down to putting the time in into a good sketch, good composition, and that's the bones that I built it up from. And super happy with everything.